I made a wolf companion for my main character to keep her company. The wolf follows her on her journey, he can find hidden objects to dig up and fetch items so she doesn't have to pick them up by herself. And yes, of course you can also pet the good boy. My name is Toby and I'm a full-time indie game developer. With my newly formed indie studio Squareglide Games, we are working on a title called Above Snakes. Above Snakes is an isometric survival game set in the tile-based world inspired by the Old West. I realized that my main character felt a little bit lonely, so I thought, what can I do about it? I ran a Kickstarter campaign earlier this year and one of the stretch goals was to add an animal companion to the game. Lots of people were really excited about it, and so am I. Currently, our developer Mark is working on a questline in which you will rescue a wolf cub from a plague-infested wolf. As a reward, you can take care of the abandoned cub that is left behind. Sorry for the spoiler. This is the perfect opportunity to add the wolf cub as a pet companion to the game. Time to jump into Unity and get my hands dirty. As every other feature, this one starts with a floating capsule thrown into my scene. As a starting point, I wrote a very simple script that teaches the capsule to follow the player. In order to do that, I'm using Unity's AI package called NavMesh for this. My ground is a NavMesh surface and my capsule is a NavMesh agent. The cool thing is that this automatically will provide acceleration, braking and pathfinding for my companion, so I don't need to implement that myself. As a next step, I replace my capsule with the actual wolf cub model. I assigned an animation controller and set the speed variable via my code that depends on the current speed of the NavMesh agent. If speed equals 0, the idle animation is played. Great! Now I already have a wolf that follows my main character. Since there is still a lot of sliding and weird turning going on, I tweaked the values of the NavMesh agent a little until I was happy with the result. I set the destination of the wolf to be behind my character so it looks like he's actually following her. The problem is that every time that I turn or do the slightest move, the wolf is moving with me because his destination depends on the character's position. It looks like we're dancing. Therefore, I added some thresholds and counters so it won't move immediately at the slightest character movement. I think this one looks way better. The next feature I want to implement is the finding hidden objects feature. I want the companion to scan his surroundings and get alerted if there's something hidden in the ground that he can dig up. I did that using Unity Physics Overlap Sphere. In every fixed frame, an invisible sphere object is created around the wolf that checks if any diggable object is intersecting with it. The detected object is invisible to the player. I've painted this red sphere around the wolf cup to visualize the overlap sphere and a blue sphere around every detectable object. I issued the wolf to walk to his target once he found something and play a digging animation alongside with some particle effects. Once he is done digging, I reset his state and he goes back into the following mode. The found object is now visible to the player and can be picked up. I plan to extend this feature to find other hidden objects, but for now, digging is fine. I also want to let the player know that the wolf found something, so I made a little exclamation mark that floats above his head while he is chasing a target. Since Above Snakes is a survival game, you will find a lot of loot, and most of it will lay somewhere on the ground. For instance, after you chop down a tree, the resulting logs will drop on the ground and you have to pick them up. I think that this is a great opportunity for our little companion to shine and to do the work for you. I extend the already existing detection script and make it also detect items on the ground. The algorithm is roughly the same. Once he detects an item, he runs towards it. Then I snap the item to his mouth and let him return to the character. After some more polishing, it looks like this. Now we have a little companion that helps us gathering stuff. The last feature I want to make is being able to pet the wolf. I don't see any gameplay advantage in that yet, but let's be honest, this is just cute and we all want to pet him. So I make the companion interactable. Once you hover over him with your mouse, you get an option to pet him. I want an animation to play while petting and also some floating hearts particle effect. Time to jump into my graphics program and make some hearts that I can use in my particle system. I created this shine particle effect for item lying on the ground earlier, so I think I can reuse this one and make it spawn hearts instead of shiny sparkles. So I tweak some of the values of the particle system and end up with this. I think that it looks pretty good. When you pet the wolf companion, the particle system is played. As a finishing touch, I think it would be super cool to add a little color that you can customize, so your companion feels more like your own. For now, I added a little red color, and in the future I will make more color items that can be crafted and equipped. Maybe they can also provide some bonus effects. And they can have all kinds of colors and shapes. Please leave your idea in the comments below what kind of color or accessory you would like to see. My main character now has a companion that follows, fetches items, and finds and digs up hidden objects. It certainly helps not to feel so lonely anymore. If you have more ideas about what the Wolf Cup could do, please also feel free and leave a comment down below. And if you are interested in more features that we recently added to Buff Snakes, check out our first video dev vlog, in which I talk about new buildings, combat, and an exciting new fishing side quest. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and leave a thumbs up if you liked the video. Thank you for your support and see you next time!